My older brother, when he took an art course at Harvard by a man named Warner, who also did looking for art treasures in the Gobi Desert, and he ran across the caravan of Roy Chapman Andrews. Roy Chapman Andrews was the prototype for Indiana Jones, he went up to Andrews and on his camel, and he said, "Dr. Livingston, I presume," and Andrews said, "No, my name is Roy Chapman Andrews," quite irritated, and a few years later, he went to a talk by Andrews of his trip, and he said, "And on this day we met a caravan from Harvard, and he mistook me for someone named Livingston." He sent me a very nice letter on my 16th birthday. "I think you will be justified in regarding your cufflinks as antiques. Roy Chapman Andrews, who headed the aforesaid expedition, and who gave the shell fragments to me in Peking some years ago, airily fixed their age as 90 million years. But I seem to be detecting Mr. Wells, H.G. Wells' Science of Life, a tendency to fix their age nearer 50 million. Years. I am myself of a conservative nature, so that when I had to declare them at the customs authorities at the port in San Francisco, I contented myself that they were more than 100 years old. Dr. Andrews told me that the only other person to whom he had given similar pieces of the dinosaur shell was Jack Barrymore. Barrymore said that anyone who had been an actor as long as he had was accustomed to having old eggs thrown at him, all of which leaves me time and space only to wish you many happy returns of last Tuesday."